Alright, now we're back in. Let's get everything set up. It's just weird. I hate that I lost my horse. Now something people who have been watching the last few streams or last couple uploads may have noticed is the maul doesn't lose charges. And that is because where is it? There it is, recharge weapon. My gloves recharge 13 points of a weapon's charge up to the level it was when it was first equipped. Pretty dang useful, actually.
Because love to.
Oh, I really should offload some of my junk. And I found this place. Just go back to Hala. I really like this house. If I had the money, I'd build one of these in real life.
Hey.
Man, okay.
What is it with these wooden shields? I don't want to burn up again like I did back in Death. Mountain, let alone dragon fires.
Okay, I still have two fortify enchanting potions. Let's not do that yet.
record 2E55. Dragonborn ventures on valiantly, so very heroic, giving no regard to his followers' loudly grumbling stomach or need for sleep.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire.
Please don't look this way. Please don't look this way.
One can never have too many snowberries. There's a fight going on down here.
Many refuse to talk to us. They call us thieves and smugglers. I am glad to see that you are not such a one. Take a look. May your road lead you towards
that. It is a strange sight.
The white flakes that sometimes fall from the sky.
Bandits harass the caravans at every step, but Khajiit usually scared.
A few days ago we were ambushed. A nuisance, really. But many of the marauders had quick fingers.
One of them stole my moon amulet, given to me by my mother when I was just a cub. It is my only memory of home in this cold land. You are kind to offer. We believe the bandits are part of a group headquartered here. Be careful. I missed my amulet. But a life cannot be replaced as easily.
I hope that you will come to do business with us again.
Leave me alone.
I don't have time for this foolishness. Now come along quietly, and we won't have to get rough. Brother, I think she's telling the truth.
I'm not going anywhere. Now back off before I do something drastic.
She doesn't have the scar. What? Oh, you're right. We've made a mistake. Now move along before that mouth of yours gets you into trouble.
Need something?
Read anyway that has missed him.
Thank you.
But the Night Mother is mother to all. It is her voice we follow, her will. Would you dare risk disobedience? And surely, punishment?
Keep talking, little man, and we'll see who gets punished.
Oh, be quiet, you great lumbering lapdog. The man has had a long journey. You can at least be civil. Mr. Cicero, I, for one, am delighted you and the Night Mother have arrived. Your presence here signals a welcome return to tradition.
Oh, what a kind and wise wizard you are! Sure to earn our lady's favor.
You and the Night Mother are, of course, welcome here, Cicero. And you will be afforded the respect deserving of your position as keeper. Understood, husband?
Oh, yes, yes, yes! Thank you, thank you, thank you!
But make no mistake. I am the leader of this sanctuary. My word is law. Are we clear on that point?
Oh, yes, mistress! Perfectly! You're the boss!
Ah, there you are. Good. I was done speaking with that muttering fool anyway. We've got some business to discuss. I do indeed. You must go to the city of Markarth and speak with the apothecary's assistant. You'll probably find her in the Hag's Cure when the shop is open. The girl's been running her mouth. Wants an ex-lover killed. She's apparently performed the Black Sacrament. Her name is Muiri. I need you to talk to her, set up the contract, and carry it out. Just do whatever the contact wishes. Be professional, represent us well, and get the job done. Since it's your first contract, I'll let you keep whatever Muiri pays. She'll be generous, I'm sure. They always are.
So, what of the old beggar Narthi? Is it done? Has he groveled for his last septum? Congratulations. You slaughtered an emaciated beggar in cold blood. You are truly an opponent to be feared. Here's your payment. Of course she is. I hear the mining business is extremely cutthroat. And those hours, the murder, I could do this all day. Here's your payment. Good. And I hope you were careful in that lumber mill. Those splinters and rusty nails can be quite nasty. Your payment for a job well done. I'm sorry, I don't. Come see me again later.
Me? I've been part of the Dark Brotherhood from the day I first hatched. I am Shadow Scale, you see. Born under the sign of the Shadow. You must speak to that Moiri woman, correct? I have heard rumors in Windhelm. She was recently implicated in a thievery, along with her lover. The lover will likely be your target. If memory serves me correctly, he leads a group of bandits. So this may be rather interesting for you.
Right then. can take you to any of the... Where do you want to go? Climb and back, and we'll be off. Ever been to Markarth? Some say it was built by the dwarves. I don't believe a word of it, though.
Stab your back, or the ones who say they're friends, then stab your back.
My sister.
Songs. The gold medals.
Never should have come here.
Please don't kill me.
Dragonborn's adventure longer, and thus my record's bigger?
People.
Oh, you'll pay for that. Extra weight. Hi. The Gary.
Stay back. The Markarth City Guard has this all under control. There are no forsworn here.
We'll handle things from here.
I hate this city.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something in the old fort near Riften. Might consider joining up myself.
This is Markarth.
Safest city.
We need to do something about these vampire attacks.
Gods. A woman attacked right on the streets. Are you all right? Did you see what happened? A Forsworn? Strange. Well, I hope the Eight give you more peace in the future, for what it's worth.
Oh, I think you dropped this. Some kind of note. Looks important. I'd better get going.
Why are you looking at me like that? The Dark Brother... My goodness, you're really here. The Black Sacrament. It actually worked? What I need is for Elaine Dufont to die. I want him hunted down and murdered like the dog he is. I didn't know it when we were with each other, but Elaine is actually the leader of a band of cutthroats. Bandits. They're holed up in some old dwarven ruin, Raldbathar. It's near Windhelm. They use it as their base. It's where they stage their raids. I want you to go to that ruin, find Elaine Dufont, and kill him. I don't care about his friends. Do whatever you want with them. But Elaine has to die. Excellent. Once Elaine is dead, I'll pay you. In gold. I've saved up a bit. I hope that'll do. But, well, there is one more thing. If you're interested. If you can, I want you to kill someone else as well. You don't have to, not as part of our deal, but if you do, I'll pay you even more. It's Nilsine Shattershield in Windhelm. If Nilsine dies too, I'll make it worth your while. I planned to kill Elaine myself, you know. Nilsine, too. But lost my nerve. I even brewed a special poison. Lotus extract. Maybe you could use it? Just coat your weapon with it. Then... you get the idea. Make them all pay for what they've done to me.
Two murders coming right up. I was wondering why that was so easy. It's just a regular dragon. Man, those people are gonna have a surprise when they come outside and find a dragon skeleton. Something's going on with the bows. Well now. Let's just get the presentries over with.
A bad time to get lost,
and thus, my record's bigger? Oh, you'll pay for that extra weight. No, actually, you can't. Just die. I don't kill because I like to. I kill because I love to.
Man, we are so OP.
Careful! I almost dropped all the files. Perplexed as to why that first bow shot went wide. I really ought to start putting points in the lockpicking. Hey, was looking at my files.
Pardon me. Was I in your way?
these lockpicks made out of? Seriously. Good lord. I just did an expert lock easier than this.
Come on in. The Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink and clean rooms.
Well, what news? Is Elaine? Thank you. That bastard got exactly what he deserved. And I heard about Nilsine. You have more than fulfilled your part of the bargain. Please, take this. As payment and a symbol of my affection. I'll never forget you.
Never mind. I must be seeing things.
The Jarl has things under control.
Unlike my husband, Pepper, I want to...
Thank you again for resolving my...
Ah, you're back. So, how went your first real contract? A bit more exciting than what Nazir's been offering, I'd wager? Of course, dear, of course. And from what my little ravens tell me, you handled yourself quite well. Now, I need your assistance with a matter of a more personal nature. It's Cicero. Ever since he arrived, his behavior's been... well, erratic would be an understatement. I do believe he is truly mad, but it's worse than that. He's taken to locking himself in the Night Mother's chamber and talking to someone in hushed but frantic tones. Who is he speaking with? What are they planning? I fear treachery. You must understand. If Cicero is turning the others against me, against us, our family would not survive such division. Dear sister, I need you to steal into that chamber and eavesdrop on their meeting. It'll be no use clinging to the shadows. They'll see you for sure. No. You need a hiding place. Somewhere they'd never think to look. Like inside the Night Mother's coffin. Be that as it may, we have no other choice. You need to remain unseen. Now go, before they meet, and report back to me with whatever you learn. Go, quickly. Hide in the coffin before Cicero and the traitor meet.
Are we alone?
Yes.
Yes! Alone! Sweet solitude! No one will hear us, disturb us. Everything is going according to plan. The others, I've spoken to them, and they're coming around, I know it. The wizard Festus Crex. Perhaps even the Argonian, and the Unchild. What about you, Have you spoken to anyone? No? No, of course not. I do the talking, the stalking, the seeing, and the saying. And what do you do, Nothing! Not that I'm angry. No, never. Cicero understands. Cicero always understands. And obeys. You will talk when you're ready, won't you? Won't you? Sweet Night Mother.
Poor Cicero. Dear Cicero. Such a humble servant. But he will never hear my voice. For he is not the listener.
Oh, but how can I defend you? How can I exert your will if you will not speak to anyone?
Oh, but I will speak. I will speak to you, for you are the one. Yes, you. You who shares my iron tomb, who warms my ancient bones. Journey to Wallenroth. Speak with Armand Moutier.
Poor Cicero has failed you. Poor Cicero is sorry, sweet mother. I've tried so very hard, but I just can't find the listener.
Tell Cicero the time has come. All these years, darkness rises when silence dies.
treachery! Defiler! Debaser and defiler! You have violated the sanctity of the Night Mother's coffin! Explain yourself! Speak, worm! She spoke to... And there is... She said that. She said those words. To you. Darkness rises when silence dies. But those are the words, the binding words, written in the keeping tomes. The signal so I would know. Mother's only way of talking to sweet Cicero. Then, it's true. She's back. Our lady is back. She has chosen a listener. She has chosen you! All hail the listener!
By Sithis, this ends now! Back away, fool! Whatever you've been planning is over!
Are you all right? I heard the commotion. Who was Cicero talking to? Where's the accomplice? Reveal yourself, traitor!
I spoke only to the Night Mother! I spoke to the Night Mother, but she didn't speak to me! Oh, no! She spoke only to her! To the Listener!
What? The Listener? What are you going on about? What is this lunacy?
It's true! It's true! The Night Mother has spoken! The silence has been broken! The Listener has been chosen!
When I heard Cicero screaming, I knew you'd been discovered. I feared the worst. Are you all right? Then what in Sithis' name is going on? Cicero spoke to the Night Mother, but she spoke to you. Is this just more of the fool's rambling? What? So Cicero wasn't talking to anyone else. Just the Night Mother's body? And the Night Mother, who, according to everything we know, will only speak to the person chosen as listener, just spoke. Right now. To you? By Sithis. And? What did she say? Amand Motier? I have no idea who that is. But Valenrud. That I have heard of. And I know where it is. No. No! Listen, I don't know what's going on here, but you take your orders from me. Are we clear on that? The Night Mother may have spoken to you, but I am still the leader of this family. I will not have my authority so easily dismissed. I need time to think about all this. Go see Nazir. Do some work for him. I'll find you when I'm ready to discuss the matter further.
Shadow scales are all but forgotten. Ancient tradition from another time.
You reek of death, my friend. I salute you. Well then, your timing couldn't be better. As it turns out, I've got two new contracts. One rather easy assignment, and another that should prove quite a challenge. Your first target is an orc bard named Lerbuk. The other is a vampire by the name of Hearn. Happy hunting. He is, by all accounts, the worst bard in all of Skyrim. Apparently, so many people sought his death, Astrid had to hold a lottery to determine the client. He's a vampire, and has blended into human society for years. He's never far from his female companion, Hurt, also a vampire. The contract is for the male, Hearn, but you'll probably have to contend with the female, too. So for Sithis' sake, watch yourself. Go on now.
Gods, it's true, isn't it? The dragon has attacked White Rock.
Finally, someone comes in. Kick off your boots, stay a while. Let me know if there's anything I can help you with. I got nothing but time these days.
Sneaking business is going to give me a heart attack from anticipation and anxiety. What do you mean I'm being overdramatic?
Help! Someone's being attacked! What the?
Thought I heard something.
You don't get that. Or anymore. Yes, boy!
You committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense?
Fun.
You're a woman. Now come along with us. We'll take any stolen goods and you'll be free to go. After you pay the fine, of course.
It's worth it. I know there are vampires here.
kill you!
That was a good one, up. Would be nice. Fences. One too many times I went the wrong way. I mean, it has.
That's right, this is the vampire couple that,
think you can win?
Looks like I own a lumber mill now.
I was looking at my files.
Okay, teleported me. Well, then maybe I could use that to get lumber for hearthfire. that somewhere there's a secret compartment thingy. I thought there would be some sort of secret thing.
We need to talk. Look, something is happening here. I'm not sure entirely what that something is, but... well, we need to find out. If the Night Mother really did give you an order to talk to a contact, we'd be mad to ignore it. And I think we'd both agree, Cicero's brought quite enough madness to this sanctuary. So go. Go to Volenrood. It's a crypt, pretty far to the northeast. Talk to this Armand Motier, and let's see where all this leads,
Tell me, brother, are the stories true?
Word certainly travels fast, doesn't it?
But to be outnumbered 20-1.
My greatest challenge was deciding which weapon to use. I am prone to indecision. Bow, dagger, axe. In the end, I opted for my claws.
Don't let my appearance throw you off. I'm older than you, a lot older. Getting bitten by a vampire when you're 10 will do that to a girl. It's been quite a boon, looking like a child. No one ever suspects a thing. It's as rewarding as it is dangerous. Let's see what I can show you. Until next time, sister.
You reek of death, my friend. I salute you. Wonderful. The only good bard is a dead one, as far as I'm concerned. All that singing and mirth. Your payment, as per the usual.
I heard about
no sarcasm this time. You faced a vampire and lived to tell the tale. Well done. And if you contracted Sanguinari Vampiris, be sure to get that taken care of, else you'll end up like our own Babette. Unless, of course, that was your goal all along. Here's your payment. You've got people to kill, my friend. Best get to...
Sister.
must die. Protocol to eradicate enemy engaged. Let the killing commence. Sorry, was looking at my files.
you!
By the almighty divines, you've come. You've actually come. This dreadful black sacrament thing, it worked.
Yes, so it would seem. Well, I won't waste your time. I would like to arrange a contract.
Hey,
several, actually.
Guess what we'll find in this.
I dare say. The work I'm offering has more significance than anything your organization has experienced in, well, centuries. As I said, I want you to kill several people. You'll find the targets as well as their manners of elimination quite varied. I'm sure someone of your disposition will probably even find it enjoyable. But you should know that these killings are but a means to an end, for they pave the way to the most important target. The real reason I'm speaking with a cutthroat in the bowels of this detestable crypt, for I seek the assassination of the Emperor. Oh, wonderful. You don't know how happy I am to hear you say that. So much has led to this day. So much planning and maneuvering. It's as if the very stars have finally aligned. But I digress. Here, take these to your superior. Rexus, the items.
Here.
The sealed letter will explain everything that needs to be done. The amulet is quite valuable. You can use it to pay for any and all expenses.
Sorry. Was looking at my files.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the dead actually did mind you looking around.
Careful! I almost chopped all the...
Probably gonna stream for another hour.
Channel switched.
Or we can just stay in the lobby.
Honestly, it's just been quiet up here. I'm just reading Imgur stories.
Yeah, mostly I made that room just to avoid Dawn's Herbita appearing randomly in streams.
A video.
Yeah. Which I am streaming right now. Let's see.
I was gonna say, I believe XCast, I think that's what it's called, can have separate video and audio streams with that up, if I remember correctly.
Well, that's okay. Not the issue, sure. It's just the issue if I'm up here so. In the main room.
Did you meet this Motier? What did he want?
Don will hop in with impunity, so I had made the two separate live streaming rooms.
You're joking.
Hmm.
What's this? By Sithis, you're not joking. To kill the Emperor of Tamriel. The Dark Brotherhood hasn't done such a thing since the assassination of Pelagius. As a matter of fact, no one has dared assassinate an Emperor of Tamriel since the murder of Uriel Septim, and that was 200 years ago. No, she certainly wouldn't. And, for whatever reason, she chose to relay Motier's information to you. I don't know exactly what's going on here, if you're the listener, or this is some fluke, or what, but what we now have before us... You're damn right we'll accept it. If we pull this off, the Dark Brotherhood will know a fear and respect we haven't seen in centuries. You think I'd abandon an opportunity to lead my family to glory? But this is all so much to take in. I need time to read the letter and figure out where we go from here. And this amulet. I'm thinking we need that amulet appraised. I want to know where it came from, how much it's worth, and if we can actually get away with selling it. And there's only one man who can give us what we need. Delvin Mallory. He's a fence, a private operator. Works out of the Ratway in Riften. Give me the letter. Bring Mallory the amulet. Find out everything you can and sell it if he's willing. He'll offer a letter of credit. That's fine. Delvin Mallory and the Dark Brotherhood have... history. He can be trusted.
Hey!
I'm really getting tired of
the Thieves Guild has Maven
when
Black
you borrowed the money, you said you'd pay it back on time.
One snap of your fingers and you could end up in Riften jail.
How was I to know the shipment
would get one? Did you feel that? Happened. It feels like... What? By the way, isn't it time for dinner yet?
Trees. Beautiful. Reminds me of autumn.
Someone there. Well, they're everywhere. Hey! Fighting. Oh, thanks
another day.
Yes. Because no game is complete without a bear.
Just ask Furin.
Let's not. Get 50 memes as a response.
We were talking earlier today about his dream of creating Baron Farm.
Looking for it? Oh, now you must be lost. Best you scurry off while you're able. The rat way, well, it has a habit of swallowing up the uninvited. Oh, I see. Well, now. How is Astrid doing these days, huh? Tell her to stop by sometime. We'd have a drink. Catch up. Ah, but we could discuss that later, yeah? What does the Brotherhood need? Let's see. Where, oh, where did you get this? No, don't answer. I don't want to know. This is an amulet of the Emperor's Elder Council. Specially crafted for each member, who have a small fortune. Ain't something you give up lightly. Look, it ain't my business to tell the Dark Brotherhood its business. But if you killed a member of the Elder Council, you better believe. Buy it. This. An Elder Council amulet. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, indeed. Oh, wait just one moment. Here. Is a letter of credit, usable by Astrid only, for any service or item I can provide, as per our standard arrangement. You bring that back to your lovely mistress, with my regards.
So, yeah. Gentlemen?
If you're gonna link something, I can't exactly look at it. I am in the middle of a stream.
Fair enough. I know Trek, you can watch it.
Good, you're back. Well, what did Mallory have to say? Is the amulet authentic?
I don't want to know.
The Elder Council? Oh, now that explains quite a bit. Motier, you naughty, naughty boy. Hiring the Dark Brotherhood to help you rise beyond your station. Delicious. Was Mallory willing to buy the amulet? Splendid. Then we're ready to begin. Or, more specifically, you're ready to begin. After all, you're the one the Night Mother spoke to. Now then, I hope you have something nice to wear, because you're going to a wedding. Well, more like the public reception. It should be a lovely affair. You'll mingle with the guests, eat some cake. Stab the bride. Oh, yes. You've got to kill the bride. At her wedding. And they say romance is dead. Her name is Vittoria Vici. She oversees the East Empire Company's business holdings in Solitude. The wedding is being held in that city, at the Temple of the Divines. Her death will cause an uproar. Which is exactly what we want. Vici is likely to address her guests frequently, as is the wedding custom. Kill her when she does that, and I promise you a significant bonus. Now go, and give my best to the bride. Off to Solitude with you. Time to give the Emperor some real motive. To visit Skyrim.
Dropped all the files.
Murder over in Riften. Some old lady who runs an orphanage. Those poor children must be heartbroken. Some are saying the Sijic monks have been seen in Skyrim. They're an ancient order.
Did I remember to record that last time we went to an inn, and you got really drunk and made love to a... Oh yeah, I did. It's right here.
Someday soon, you will all see battle, and what you do here today may well save your lives.
Typical Imperial rot. You speak of Skyrim like you know the land, know its people. You're from Cyrodiil. You know nothing about us. Nothing!
Oh, I know enough. I know those troublemaking Stormcloaks refuse to submit to Imperial. Such sedition. Why, it's treason.
And when the elves marched into your beloved Cyrodiil, and everyone took up arms against them, wasn't that treason? Against the Dominion, huh?
Why, that's not the same thing at all. The Dominion were invaders, conquerors. We had to fight them to preserve our own way of life.
My point exactly.
Honored guests, my husband Aesgeir and I thank you for coming to our reception. We thank you for sharing the love we have for each other. Today, the problems of Skyrim are not my problems, nor are they yours. Today, we are joined in peace and happiness. So please, enjoy yourselves. I thank you all again for making this the best wedding a woman could ask for.
I hate this game sometimes.
As long as we keep our footsteps light, I don't think we'll get caught. Ugh, I shouldn't have eaten all those sweet rolls.
Doing the thing where you have to assassinate the woman at her wedding.
Right.
And I forgot that she does an instant move from downstairs to upstairs rather than actually going through the building.
Right.
So I went to go follow her, and then she popped up immediately on top, so I went and moved around, and I fired the arrow, and she turned around and just entered the door, so the arrow smacked into the door.
Committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense? Time to cleanse the Empire of its fury.
Let's just... I'm gonna murder some people. I am now currently fleeing solitude, because while sneaking and undetected and under an invisibility potion, everybody saw me kill a lady. I'm about to steal a horse. Out of the city. They lost track of me, so I stole the horse and only had to pay 130. I just straight up murdered a woman and I'm fine.
Unless we have specific business, I'm not interested. Unless we have specific business, I'm not interested.
We'll meet back up at the sanctuary.
That's not the first time in this playthrough the game has kind of gone out of its way to make sure that I botch a perfect assassination. Like when I had to kill that woman's ex-boyfriend, I was aiming right at the guy and I fired, the arrow flew to the right.
I wish I was shot.
And I was using torch arrows, so it's not like an arrow missing is going to go unnoticed when it suddenly catches a wall on fire.
The news is everywhere. Vittoria Vici, the Emperor's cousin, butchered at her own wedding. Well done. Let's see His Eminence try to ignore this. With Vici's murder, you've started us down a path the Dark Brotherhood hasn't traveled in centuries. The assassination of an emperor. And now your reward. A unique spell to summon a legend of the Dark Brotherhood. His soul serves us now in death, as his body once did in life.
Ah, and of course, a bonus for killing Vici while she addressed her guests as instructed. Gold. Simple and pure. Spend it as you will. Now then, time to proceed to the next stage of the plan. Go and speak with Gabriella. She's been helping me arrange your next contract.
Still here. Thunderstorm. What's the matter? Can't handle.
What can I say? It happened just like you heard.
Dear sister, I've been waiting for you. Your next contract awaits, as I'm sure Astrid indicated.
Remarkable.
In truth, it was so easy.
With the Emperor's arrival in Skyrim now a certainty, his security service, the Penitus Oculatus, will need to begin its preparations immediately. Security is being handled by a Commander Morrow. Astrid and I have devised a plan to break the man, and in doing so, cripple the Emperor's protection. You are to slay the Commander's son, Gaius Morrow, and once he is dead, plant false evidence on his body, implicating him in a plot to kill the Emperor. He is set to leave the Penitus Oculatus outpost at Dragonbridge and inspect the security of each city in Skyrim. Go there now. Observe Gaius Morrow's departure and follow him. Waylay him in one of the cities and send his soul to Sithis. Once he's dead, plant the incriminating letter on his body and let fate take care of the rest. Oh, and one final thing. To earn your bonus, do not kill Gaius Morrow in Dragonbridge or on the road. Kill him in one of the other major cities he'll be visiting. There, the body will be discovered quickly, as will the letter implicating Gaius Morrow in the plot to assassinate the Emperor. Do that, and Astrid has authorized me to grant you a rather unique bonus. It is a special token to be given to Olava the Feeble in Whiterun. Olava is an old and dear friend, and a powerful seer. The token entitles you to a reading of your future. It's an opportunity one should not pass up. Walk in Gaius Morrow's shadow and deliver to him the judgment of Sithis.
That's too.
Tell me, sister, are the stories true?
Okay.
Father, you worry too much. I'll be fine.
I know you.
Trust me. We have nothing to say to one another.
You must be lost. The tavern is down the road a piece.
Special edition?
No, I've never actually used an EMB. I haven't really looked into it too much. I probably should, just to make the game look prettier. Let's see.
User entered your channel.
Oh god, it's a tank.
Hi, it is.
Yep, it's a tank.
So I reset my modem and router last night after I logged off.
So
how it behaves today. Well, it just doesn't make any sense that, like, I'd have a ping rate of 34 ms, and yet my packets, you know, the packet loss would be at 24%.
You go what, straight modem, or do you go modem then router?
Modem to router. And the router is directly connected to my computer.
Could be ports?
It didn't do it before, so I highly doubt it.
My sneaking level is so ridiculous that I went to go steal that guy's schedule, Trekkie, so I could find out what cities he'd be in and what days. And I literally crouched down in front of the guard, or beside the guard, took a little step to the right, and became invisible.
By Ismail, you did it! You killed the dragon.
Don't know why I didn't... Why you have to do that all the time, Hank?
Wait, what now?
Private message.
Well, I got that. I'm watching it now, but we talked, and so I didn't know what you said.
Oh.
you are Dragonborn. But such a thing, surely. It's not possible.
Okay, what is it with these wooden shields? I don't want to burn up again like I did.
Come on in. Let me know if you need anything, or take a seat by the fire, and I'll send someone over.
You look like someone who can hold their liquor. How about a friendly contest with the staff?
That's a very accurate rant of his.
Yep.
Such a very political-esque rant. Wouldn't you agree, Tank?
Indeed. Back alley deals.
Well, it's true if you think about it.
Oh, it's totally true. I'm sorry, our romantic getaway turned into an actual getaway. You know cops.
Keep back, citizen. I have important business I must attend to.
Well met, Kinsman.
Protocol to eradicate enemy engaged. Let the killing commence. You can run. No, actually, you can't. Just stop. Well, now, just lie down and die.
We need the cousin of the Emperor was murdered in solitude at her own damn wedding. Not a chance we would have let that happen here.
You hear the news? Those damn mages blew up Winterhold. Guess it was just a matter of time.
It's nice being Thane of Whiterun.
Is it?
Well, I just brutally murdered the guy in the middle of Whiterun while fighting the guards. The moment I planted the letter, they're like, oh, okay, never mind.
Or joined your channel.
And that's why I made that other channel.
So go back down there.
Well, I didn't want to be alone because you guys are antisocial assholes.
We know we are.
But you don't want.
I make.
You just call us antisocial assholes.
Yes, I have. I had the live, but you can join channel. And I sat in there for I don't know how long with these two jackasses up here. Tank wasn't around. Not to say the tank isn't a jackass.
Thanks for not leaving me out.
And mostly it's so that if you were to pop in on me while I'm down there, you wouldn't go hop, 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 hop.
Okay, we're hearing
yes,
you on a loop.
I know, as does Astrid. You have done well.
You're probably also picking up the audio from my Twitch stream because I do have it down there.
Pressing matter to deal with.
I've got it playing on my phone so I can monitor.
It's been an incident. You should proceed into the sanctuary. I'll let Astrid
explain.
But hey,
Tricky, I'm going on air in a few minutes if you want to tune in.
Oh God, why?
That's right. That's right, listeners/watchers. Go listen to Don Burrito and everybody else on KPR.
KPR.rocks.
There you go.
Thank you, dear.
Free listening.
You are most
Isn't
kind.
That an amazing
the jester's
short
cut
URL?
Feels as bad as it looks.
Don't brag too much.
Damn it. This never should have happened.
Seriously, though, how awesome is that
better.
For a radio station?
We knew
short
better,
URL?
And still we let our guards down.
It's pretty awesome.
I'll admit, even I'm having a hard time disagreeing with you.
Marrow is dead, I know. But we've got bigger problems right now.
Alright, I'll talk to y'all later.
The fool went absolutely berserk. He wounded Yuzara, tried
channel.
To kill me, and then he fled. I knew that lunatic couldn't be trusted.
Right, well, back to what we were talking
well,
about.
True, I'm afraid. Cicero was a little whirlwind. Slash this
way we were talking
that.
About something.
It would have been funny if he weren't trying to murder me.
Yeah, something about...
Don't forget the ranting and raving.
Back alleys.
About the Night Mother, how she was the
and
true
now
leader
you have to be
of the
careful
Dark
of
Brotherhood.
Them.
And Astrid was just a pretender.
Look, we've got to deal with this situation. You've got to deal with... Look, we've got to deal with this situation. You've got to deal with this situation. I want you to find that miserable little fool and end his life. But first, find my husband. Make sure he's all right. After the attack... Onbjorn flew into a rage. When Cicero left, Onbjorn went after him. They disappeared into the wild. Search Cicero's room. Maybe there's something in there that sheds some light on where he might have gone. Let me know the minute you find something. I've got to see to Vizara and calm everyone down.
Bested by a fool. Who's the fool now?
Have you found something? Good. Good. Does it say where he may be headed? The Dawnstar Sanctuary? Whatever for. Never mind, it doesn't matter. You need to leave. Now. Every moment counts, so I want you to take my horse. His name is Shadowmere. You'll find him outside by the pool. Let's just say he's one of us. Find Arnbjorn. Make sure my husband's all right. And then, send that jester's twisted little soul to the void, in as many pieces as possible. Damnable jester.
Yay, I have Shadowmere.
Right.
Undead horse is best horse. I'm not even sure, is Shadowmere an undead horse or like a demonic horse?
I'd say it's probably a demonic horse.
Because I know you can get quite, you can literally get an undead skeletal horse in Dawnguard.
Uh-huh.
It's kind of rude, judging him, labeling him. It's just a horse. Very, very angry horse, but still a horse.
What did you just find in Fallout 4?
Nothing.
Because that...
Wow.
...that I want.
You just what?
Giant ass pizza.
It's not a pizza made of ass or an ass that is pizza. It's just a.
Should have figured Astrid would send
very
you.
Very large. Four pizzas in one pizza.
Ugh, what gave it away?
Basically four deep dishes.
Yeah.
Inside.
Gotta admit that little
Chester's
good with that butter knife. But don't worry.
That's a party pizza, alright.
I
all
gave right. as good as I got. In there, through the door. Some old sanctuary by the looks of it. I would have followed him, but I don't know the phrase. Alright, you convinced me. Doubt I'd be much good to you anyway. The little fop cut me pretty deep. But I slashed him good. Pretty sure I severed an artery. Don't know what you're gonna find in there. But you can probably just follow the blood.
What is life's...
So, 14 by 14.
Listener! Is that you? Oh, I knew you'd come! The best to defeat the best!
You're better with math.
Wait, what?
You're a stupid wolf.
just trying to figure out. So, if it's 14 slices, if it's 14 by 14, I'm just trying to figure out how many slices there are.
5D.
For that whole thing.
It's all squares.
Forget it.
So
I need a moment here.
Your traditional, you know, normal slices.
No! Yeah, that was the script. You kill the keeper or I kill the listener! Now that's madness!
It's also probably, what do you think, 4 feet by 4 feet?
Give or take.
No! I just figured out how many squares.
Rest in pieces. It'll be easier for the skeevers to chew.
It actually looks like it's already been cut, so that can tell you right there.
I know, that's why I had the estimate of like 14.
I guess I can include you on
the outside.
Annihilation record. Die!
Come down to you.
Okay, then. Onwards, I guess.
Not what I used to be. Surrender. Traitor? Me? Silly assassin. So confused. So confused. They say I'm mad. If I'm a traitor, so are you. Have you not heard the maiden's voice? Are you not the listener? So walk away. Let poor Cicero live. Tell Astrid you did the job. Strangled your own poor Cicero. A tiny white.
Okay, so basically, I finally found.
Go on.
200 square slices.
Yeah, 196. I said that.
Yeah, it's known as the Giant Sicilian.
Oh god, 4.5 feet? Bastards.
Are you guys, like, wanting pizza or something?
Not me, but holy crap, that thing's huge.
$250?
How many slices?
200.
I'd need a few hours.
Careful!
Yeah. No, yeah, okay. There's no. I need a few hours. This is a case of. This'll feed a village in Africa for
a
month.
I would need a few hours.
I don't.
You
think
say
so.
That now.
You're talking to a guy that if he's bored and has the money to spare can down, you know, two orders of hot wings and two large pizzas by himself in about an hour and a half.
Arnbjorn is safe,
a good one?
And
look
for that
link
you
I
have my
posted.
Thanks. But what of the fool?
So isn't it a deep dish, though? A few hours? I don't think you can do it.
No, it doesn't look like it's a deep dish. Looks like it's just...
Arnbjorn is safe, and for that you have my Excellent. Once again, you've proven yourself a
looks
born
like it's
assassin.
Just regular crust.
Tell you what. Why don't you hold on to Shadowmere a while longer? He's a fine steed. And hasn't been ridden nearly as much as he should lately. And now that this Cicero mess has been mopped up, we can get back to the matter at hand, There's just one more target before we strike out at the Emperor. Have you by chance heard of the Gourmet? Read his cookbook? It's become quite a phenomenon. The Gourmet is scheduled to cook for the Emperor at a special dinner. You'll kill him, steal his writ of passage, and assume
Sweet
the role
Jesus,
of Master Chef.
Huge.
Festus has been spearheading this part of the assassination plan. He's close to uncovering the identity of the Gourmet. You should report to him.
Now you see why the rest of us...
Until next time.
I don't believe Alistair would All right. be...
I'm gonna end the stream here, because I've been doing it for 2.5 hours, and I'm gonna look at this pizza, and I'm gonna prove you guys wrong. Alright, so I'm gonna save.